George Floyd!
Just about everyone knows the name George Floyd. His death sparking months of massive media coverage and social movements, especially in Minneapolis. So let's verify. How did the court find an impartial jury for the Derek Chauvin trial? Our sources, court footage, and four criminal law experts. The initial jury pool was 326 people. Over the past 3 weeks, dozens took the stand, getting grilled on their opinions of this case, Black Lives Matter, policing, and more. The key question, can they set those views aside and be impartial, presuming Derek Chauvin is innocent until proven guilty?
I can be fair and impartial.
I definitely hope for a specific outcome, and I don't know that that would change.
We always have ideas about what really happened.
Anthony Farley is a law professor and former prosecutor.
As jurors, we listen a different way. We take into account what's been presented to us by the lawyers, and we're instructed about the elements that the prosecution has to prove.
I'm going to excuse you from this case.
Judge Peter Cahill released dozens of jurors.
I don't think I have to accept a juror's statement. I will be fair and impartial when everything I see, the totality of the circumstances, is they can't be.
I am exercising a peremptory.
The defense got 18 strikes to excuse jurors, three more than usual.
The state will strike.
The state could cut 10.
The judge and the prosecution are worried about what we call an appeal issue.
That's law professor Kimberly Whaley.
It's, of course, impossible to impanel a jury of people who have not heard about this case.
Jurors were told to avoid all news.
I'm seeing the headlines every day.
Complicating the process, a $27 million settlement between the city of Minneapolis and George Floyd's family reached during jury selection.
When I heard that, I almost gasped.
That juror was released. So were two others who had already been picked.
What has it done to their perception of the presumption of innocence?
The defense asked the judge to delay the trial and move it out of Minneapolis. Judge Cahill denied that.
Unfortunately, I think the pretrial publicity in this case will continue.
Where are they going to move it to? Mars?
Do you think it's even possible to find a truly impartial jury here?
Yes.
Rachel Paulos is a professor at the University of St. Thomas Law School and a former U.S. attorney for Minnesota.
The knowledge that most people have of this case comes from a videotape, the authenticity of which no one disputes. That doesn't make you biased, it makes you knowledgeable.
And law professor Rachel Moran argues it may actually benefit Chauvin that so many jurors have seen that video of the moments before Floyd's death.
That very evidence they have seen is a big piece of what the state wants people to say is the reason he should be guilty of murder. And some of those jurors are saying they have seen pieces of that evidence and they can still be fair or presume him innocent.
The 14 jurors all passed the standards of the defense, the state, and the court to be impartial.
We'll be on this jury.
They'll decide if Chauvin is guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. With your Verify, I'm Gabe Cohen.